today's video, going to be replacing the valve cover gaskets on this 3.4 liter Toyota 4Runner. And right there you can see why. And here's the passenger side. You can see it's just as bad. So we're going to go ahead and replace them. Want to disconnect the negative battery terminal, so if we have to touch any electrical, it doesn't mess up anything. We're just going to start taking off everything. First we're going to do, take off the intake, 10 millimeter. Take off our cables to the throttle body. ...14 millimeter for the throttle cable bracket. ...10 millimeter for the cable bracket. Another 10 mil right here. Now you can go ahead and grab this cable bracket and just move it out the way. 10 millimeter right here on this bracket. ...10 millimeter for this cable bracket. Move this out the way. Pull off the vacuum hose. 10 millimeter for this bracket. Pull it off. Unplug this connector. Unplug the top connector. Now we're going to take out the throttle bottle heater lines. We're going to take off this vacuum hose from the valve cover to the intake manifold. Take off this vacuum hose. Pull inboard on the tab on this plug, pull up, just let it hang. We're going to separate the upper and lower intake manifold, 12 millimeter. Behind this green connector, there's one more vacuum hose. You just gotta pull it off. No clamp or anything. Here's your intake manifold. 10 millimeter for these ground wires. From this bracket to the lower intake manifold, 12 millimeter bolt. ...10 millimeter to this bracket on the underside. ...10 millimeter on this bolt in the back. ...12 millimeter for this hose bracket. What's holding the lower intake manifold is one nut right there, one bolt, two, three bolt, and then one nut back here. On the passenger side, we're going to go ahead and take off these plugs to the coil packs. Millimeter. Ten millimeter for this bracket for the injector harness. So now what we're going to do is put gasket maker on all the mating surfaces on the timing cover. Three inch pounds. Now we'll go ahead and install the lower intake manifold. Go ahead and hand thread our bolts. Foot-pounds. Same thing, 13 foot-pounds. I wasn't able to record the last little bit just because my camera overheated. Just got to make sure you put all your throttle cables, all your vacuum lines, plug those back in. The one that we took off originally. This one goes to the air box that comes from down there. Just pretty much just go over everything, making sure anything that you touch to come off is put back on. All right, now we're going to go ahead and start it. And there you go. Back up and running. And that's how you replace the valve cover gaskets on these 4Runners. Hopefully the video helps y'all. Y'all have a good one.